Hello, hi friends, this is Akash, and today I will share you a location, a heritage site in Delhi, Firoz Shah Kotla Fort. As you can see in the map, this is located in the central Delhi side location. And on Google Maps, you can see the reviews, the photos about how the location looks. And this is not a very big fort, but it is a very relevant and very old heritage building in Delhi. So as you can see from Google Maps, Firoz Shah Kotla Stadium is just next to this Firoz Shah Kotla Fort, and from the metro station nearby is your Delhi Gate metro station, which is 550 meters, about 2 minutes drive, or you can take a bus because it's a bus route, so you can get a bus also, and by auto or your e-rickshaw, they will charge you 50 to 60 rupees depending at the what time you are coming at the location. Now I will show you how to book your tickets from the Archaeological Survey of India. Just go to their site, select Delhi, the Firoz Shah Kotla Fort, the date and the time at which you are going to visit. Then enter your nationality, Indian. Mention your email ID, your name and your identity ID number, and just click to proceed to pay. The ticket price might vary depending on what nationality you are from. The page will load and you can select the mode by which you want to pay, by e-wallet. As you can see, I paid it through Paytm, and the ticket cost was only 20 rupees. After putting the OTP, you will be able to download the e-ticket in the form of PDF. Also, the same ticket will be mailed to your email ID that you mentioned. If you are coming by your own vehicle, I would suggest that the parking is available outside the fort area, but it's not an authorized parking. It is just a common parking of like different gardens surrounding the fort. So you can park your vehicle outside the fort, and just 2 minutes walk, you can go and enter the fort area. Kotla, Firoz Shah. This fortress, also known as Kushk-e-Firuz, was the citadel of Firoz Shah Tughlaq AD 1351 to 1388. He built it along the banks of Yamuna in Firozabad, the fifth city of Delhi, which extended from Hauz Khas to Pir Kazib near Hindu Rad Hospital, with an entrance through the Barbican main gate flanked by a bastion on either sides
of the west, the citadel contained palaces, pillared halls, mosques, a pigeon tower, and a ball. Among these were the famed tall pyramidal structure supporting the Ashokan pillar or the lat and the Jami Masjid. While the gateway from the southern enclosure has been later closed, there are also the remains of a gateway for the northern enclosure. Several flights of steps on the east lead down to the old river bank. Most of the building material from Firozshah city was robbed to build Shahjahanabad, 1638 to 1648. Firozshah Tughlaq was a renowned builder whose reign is credited with the construction of several mosques, hunting lodges, reservoirs for irrigation, embankment and caliques in and around Delhi.
The Firozshah Kotla or Kotla was a fortress built by Sultan Firozshah Tughlaq to the house his version of Delhi city called Firozabad. A pristine polished sandstone topra Ashoka pillar from the 3rd century BC rises from the palace crumbling remains, one of the many pillars of Ashoka left by the Mauryan Empire. It was moved from Topra Kalan in Pong Ghati of Yamunanagar district in Haryana to Delhi under order of Firozshah Tughlaq of Delhi Sultanate, and he re-erected it its present location in 1356. The original inscription on the obelisk is primarily in Brahmin script, but language was Prakrit, with some Pali and Sanskrit added later. The inscription was successfully translated in 1837 by James Prinsep. This and other ancient lats, pillars, obelisk have earned Firozshah Tughlaq and Delhi Sultanate fame for its architectural patronage. Other than the Ashokan pillar, the fort complex also houses the Jami Masjid, mosque, a Bauli, and a large garden complex. Built in 14th century, materials, granite stone and lime mortar. Firozshah Tughlaq history. Firozshah Tughlaq, 1351 to 1388. The Sultan of Delhi established the fortified city of Firozabad in 1354 as the new capital of Delhi Sultanate and included in it the site of present Firozshah Kotla. Kotla literally means fortress or citadel. The pillar, also called as obelisk or lat, is an Ashokan column attributed to Mauryan ruler Ashoka. The 13.1 meters high column made of polished sandstone and dating from the 3rd century BC was brought from Ambala in the 14th century under order of Firozshah. It was installed on a three-tiered arcade pavilion near the Congregational Mosque. Inside the Sultanate Fort, in centuries that followed, much of the structure and buildings near it were damaged as subsequent rulers dismantled them and reused the spoilia as the building materials. In the pre-independence era, due to lack of auditoriums in the capital, most classical music performances were staged here or at the Qutub complex. Later, Ibrahim Aik Zai, then head of NSD, staged his landmark production of Dharamveer Bharti's Andha Yug here
and its premiere in 1964 was attended by Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru.
Jami Masjid. Jami Masjid is one of the most ancient and largest surviving mosque and monument still in use. Architecturally, it was built on a series of underground cell made of quartzite, so covered with limestone. It is surrounded by a large courtyard with a cloister and a prayer hall. The prayer hall, now in complete ruins, was once used for royal ladies. The masjid and its architecture is an example of Tughlaq architecture. The entrance of Jami Masjid lies on the northern side. It is connected by a causeway to the pyramidal structure of Ashokan pillar. The mosque was visited by Sultan Timur in 1398 AD to say his prayers. He was spellbound by its beautiful and constructed a mosque in Samarkand in Mawarnahir, imitating the design of Masjid. This mosque is also known as a place where Imad-ul-Mulk, a Mughal prime minister called the Emperor Alamgir II, murdered in 1759 AD. The Ashokan pillar, which is now with Firoz Shah Kotla, is towards the north of Jama Masjid Mosque. The pillar was first erected by King Ashoka between 273 and 236 BC in Topra, Kalan, Yamunanagar district, Haryana. Of note, there is another Ashokan pillar that is seen installed near the Hindu Rao Hospital, also erected by King Ashoka in Meerut. This pillar, however, was unfortunately broken into 5 pieces after it was damaged during an explosion. The pillar was neglected for a century up till 1838, when after the revolt of 1857, Raja Hindu Rao took charges to transfer the Ashokan pillar broken pieces to Kolkata's Asiatic Society. Within a year, the structure was put together and re-established. Both the Ashokan pillar were carefully wrapped with a cotton silk and were kept on a bed of reed made of raw silk. These were hence transported on a massive carriage attached with 42 wheels and drawn meticulously by 200 men from their original places in Delhi by the Firoz Shah Tughlaq to avoid any damages during the journey. Upon reaching Delhi, they were then transported on a huge boat to their final destination, one within Firoz Shah Kotla and the other on the ridge near Delhi University, Bara, Hindu Rao Hospital. Scripts on stone. The Sultanate wanted to break and reuse the Ashokan pillar for minaret. Firoz Shah Tughlaq, however, decided to erect it near the mosque instead. At the time of reinstallation of obelisk in Delhi in 1356, no one knew the meaning of the script engraved in the stone. About 500 years later, the script Brahmin was deciphered by James Prinsep in 1837 with the help of scripts discovered on other pillars and tablets in the South Asia. Translation. Inscription on the 3rd century pillar describes King Devanampiya's policies and appeal to the people and future generation of the kingdom in matter of dharma, just virtue, life, moral precepts and freedoms. Some extracts of the translation per James Prince are as follows. Along the high road, I have caused fig trees to be planted that they may be for shades to animal and men. and let these other, the most skillful in the sacred office, discreet and respectfully use the most persuasive effort, acting on the heart of eyes of the children, to impart enthusiasm and instruction in the Dharma. And whatsoever benevolent act have been done by me, the same shall be prescribed as a duties to the people who follow after me, and in the manner shall be influenced and increased by manifest, by service to father and mother, by service to scribes, pastors, by respectful demeanor to the aged and full years, by kindness to learn the orphan and destitute and servants and mistribe tribe. And religion increased synth among men by two separate processes, by the performance of the religious office and the security against the persecution, and that religion may be free from persecution of men, that it may increase through the absolute prohibition to put to death any living being or sacrifice aught that draweth breath. For such an object is all this done, that it may endure to my sons and sons, as long the sun and the moon shall last. Let stone pillar be prepared, and let the edict of Dharma, religion, be engraved thereon, that it may endure unto the remotest ages. Bauli, the well. The circular Bauli, which means step well, lies towards the northwestern side of Ashokan pillar. It lies in the heart of large garden constructed in the form of subterranean apartments, and a large underground canal built in the eastern side, through which the water runs into the well. This is the only circular Bauli in Delhi, and also one of the fourth Bauli where the tank is not separated from the well. It once has a roof on it, which collapsed long ago, exposing the tank at the second level. Originally it had an entire from east and west, but now only the west side is accessible. Due to security reasons, the Bauli is kept locked, by permission to visit can be obtained easily for research purpose from Delhi Circle Office of Archaeological Survey of India. Prayers at the fort. Every Thursday there is a huge crowd at the fort. It is popularly believed that the jinns descend at the fort from the heavens and accept requests and wishes from the people. A lot of wishes penned down on paper can be seen on the walls within the premises. The association to jinn seems to be not found to be old. It's only since 1977, a few months after the end of emergency, that there are first records of people starting to come to Firoz Shah Kotla in large numbers. Hello, hi friends, this is Akash, and today I will share you a location, a heritage site in Delhi, Firoz Shah Kotla Fort. As you can see in the map, this is located in the central Delhi side location. And on Google Maps, you can see the reviews, the photos about how the location looks. And this is not a very big fort, but it is a very relevant and very old heritage building in Delhi. So as you can see from Google Maps, Firoz Shah Kotla Stadium is just next to this Firoz Shah Kotla Fort. And from the metro station nearby is your Delhi Gate metro station, which is 550 meters, about 2 minutes drive, or you can take a bus because it's a bus route, so you can get a bus also, and by auto or your e-rickshaw, they will charge you 50 to 60 rupees depending at the what time you are coming at the location. Now I will show you how to book your tickets from the Archaeological Survey of India. Just go to their site, select Delhi, the Firoz Shah Kotla Fort, the date and the time at which you are going to visit. Then enter your nationality, Indian. Mention your email ID, your name and your identity ID number, and just click to proceed to pay. The ticket price might vary depending on what nationality you are from. The page will load and you can select the mode by which you want to pay, by e-wallet. As you can see, I paid it through Paytm, and the ticket cost was only 20 rupees. After putting the OTP, you will be able to download the e-ticket in the form of PDF. Also, the same ticket will be mailed to your email ID that you mentioned. If you are coming by your own vehicle, I would suggest that the parking is available outside the fort area, but it's not an authorized parking. It is just a common parking of like different gardens surrounding the fort. So you can park your vehicle outside the fort, and just 2 minutes walk, you can go and enter the fort area. The Firoz Shah Kotla or Kotla was a fortress built by Sultan Firoz Shah Tughlaq to the house his version of Delhi city called Firozabad. A pristine polished sandstone Topra Ashoka pillar from the 3rd century BC rises from the palace. Crumbling remains, one of the many pillars of Ashoka left by the Mauryan Empire. It was moved from Topra Kalan in Pong Ghati of Yamunanagar district in Haryana to Delhi under order of Firoz Shah Tughlaq of Delhi Sultanate, and he re-erected it its present location in 1356. The original inscription on the obelisk is primary in Brahmin script, but language was Prakrit, with some Pali and Sanskrit added later. The inscription was successfully translated in 1837 by James Prinsep. This and other ancient lats, pillars, obelisk have earned Firoz Shah Tughlaq and Delhi Sultanate fame for its architectural patronage. Other than the Ashokan pillar, the fort complex also houses the Jami Masjid, mosque, a Bauli, and a large garden complex. Built in 14th century, materials granite stone and lime mortar. Firoz Shah Tughlaq history. Firoz Shah Tughlaq 1351 to 1388. The Sultan of Delhi established the fortified city of Firozabad in 1354 as the new capital of Delhi Sultanate and included in it the site of present Firoz Shah Kotla. Kotla literally means fortress or citadel. The pillar, also called as obelisk or lat, is an Ashokan column attributed to modern ruler Ashoka. The 13.1 meters high column made of polished sandstone and dating from the 3rd century BC was brought from Ambala in the 14th century under order of Firoz Shah. It was installed on a three-tiered arcade pavilion near the Congregational Mosque. Inside the Sultanate Fort, in centuries that followed, much of the structure and buildings near it were damaged as subsequent rulers dismantled them and reused the spoilia as the building materials. In the pre-independence era, due to lack of auditoriums in the capital, most classical music performances were staged here or at the Qutub complex. Later, Ibrahim Aizai, then head of NSD, staged his landmark production of Dharamveer Bharti's Andha Yug here, and its premiere in 1964 was attended by Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru. Jami Masjid. Jami Masjid is one of the most ancient and largest surviving mosque and monument still in use. Architecturally, it was built on a series of underground cells made of quartzite, so covered with limestone. It is surrounded by a large courtyard with a cloister and a prayer hall. The prayer hall, now in complete ruins, was once used for royal ladies. The masjid and its architecture is an example of Tughlaq architecture. The entrance of Jami Masjid lies on the northern side. It is connected by a causeway to the pyramidal structure of Ashokan pillar. The mosque was visited by Sultan Timur in 1398 AD to say his prayers. He was spellbound by its beautiful and constructed a mosque in Samarkand in Mawarnahir, imitating the design of Masjid. This mosque is also known as a place where Imad-ul-Mulk, a Mughal prime minister, got the Emperor Alamgir II murdered in 1759 AD.
पास है।